getting ready to go run the Tough Mudder here in about 2 hours is my start time. So I've got 45 minutes to get there and get checked in. So I'm totally fine on time, which is nice. Packed, got my GoPro stuff, you and this one, that's all packed. Got my bags packed. I think I'm ready to go. I mean, had plenty to eat yesterday, got enough sleep, not great. It was raining like crazy the last few days, so we actually got a notice. I got a notice from Tough Mudder. So they sent out a weather advisory. At the end of it, it said, the upside of the rain, there is certainly no lack of mud to run in. I mean, yeah. I don't know what to expect, basically. I actually almost considered chickening out. I felt the voice inside me tell me, like, you know what, this is starting to be too much trouble. Just go home. And I'm like, well, I've spent a lot of money on this. And they're like, nah, just go home. And then finally, I just got to, I'm like, no, I need to see what happens. I'm not just going to give up before I've even tried. I'm going to just go show up. I'm going to go to the gate, see how it's working, make sure everything's fine. Then I'm going to show up and go run this dang thing. All right. 7:28 a.m. Heading there now. Got me a little, got me half a bagel and with some peanut butter. That was actually super delicious. Wasn't gonna have breakfast, but well, thought, you know what? I'll have a little. I may get hungry later and I don't wanna get hungry on the race. As a complete aside, doesn't matter to the race, but since I was here from out of town, I picked myself up some new road running shoes, some new zero drop shoes. So I'm going all in on the zero drop thing because it's been really helping. So I am pulling on to the property right now and it seems to be fine. Okay, there's a bunch of cars up there. Oh, that shows up right over there. Oh wow, yeah, there's the obstacles. The excitement's kicking in. I remember feeling this last year, like that, oof. Just the excitement of what's coming. But I'm a whole hour early. Last time I was fretting and worrying about, you know, oh, I gotta rush, gotta get to where I was at. Because it was my first time, I didn't know. But since I've done one before, I know, like, I don't need to be in any particular hurry. I can just relax, take my time. It is not going to take an hour to get up there, get checked in, and get to the staging area. And even then, I got a 45-minute window that I start in. So, I'm just glad I'm here because now it's chill time. So, where do I go?
Here you go.
Follow him?
Yep. Next to that red car.
Perfect. Thanks. All right. So, we're here. It is cold and wet. I'm gonna go ahead and put on my shoes here. Oh, I'm cold. I'm not gonna lie, I think this has the very real potential to be quite miserable. It's supposed to be cloudy today, so I don't know if I'm even gonna get a lot of direct sunlight.
Morning.
Welcome. Warm day.
It's warm, of course.
I'd hate for it to be too hot. I'd sweat. That'd be sad.
What can you do with it being too hot?
It's great. Yes. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Definitely no shortage of mud. This will be a very, very, very muddy event. Now, here's the really neat thing. So you come in right there in that. Now you might notice this stuff right here. I want to point out, this is an obstacle right here. So this thing right here, it's called Mudderhorn. You climb all the way up to the top, over and go down. Now here's a really trippy thing about it that's really freaked me out last time I did this. So you see, you can see right through it the whole way up. So you can, it's not like you can't tell how high you are, but right there at the peak, you got to go over on your stomach. There's not enough room because there's netting over the entire thing up high. And that netting forces you to have to be on your stomach. And so you have to look down and see the ground. And you really get a sense of just how high up you are. But so this is going to be really exciting. But anyway, let's do a walk around. Let's see what's all here before I go check my bag. Yeah. It's so muddy. Like, my feet are gonna be covered in mud before the race even starts. This electroshock therapy, this is one obstacle that I'm just straight up not looking forward to. Like, if it wasn't here, I wouldn't be like, oh, bummer, it's gone. Like, Matterhorn over there, I would straight up be sad if it wasn't here. This thing, or yeah, I would be sad if that one weren't here. This one, on the other hand, that's what I think about that one.
It was, because...
I'll be taking this back to my car. The way I do it is I take my bag, drop it off. There's a few things I'm just not going to leave my drop bag. Like, I brought my wallet in case I needed my ID. They said you need to bring it. This is now twice they said that and they didn't check my ID. So I don't know that I'm going to be bringing my ID anymore when I come to this, so I can just leave my wallet. So if you're trying to do this for advice, you take that at your, do what you want with that. Bag check. So mine went in a trash bag, just totally covered it up. So that's how bag check works, and then it's all secure. So if anybody, so again, if I want to do that, it's pretty simple. But what I do, like my wallet, my cell phone, I don't keep those here. There's plenty of time, so what I will be doing, like, they have lockers here, but honestly I don't care. I'm just gonna
run. Is coming out,
and just jogged over here to the car. I'm gonna jog as my warm up. Really kind of annoyed that I didn't think about this whole car thing. That's all right, time to have fun. Okay. So there's the staging area. I'm just gonna go ahead, because I don't really check. But I think this is the 9 o'clock staging area, so it should be fun. It is so muddy. I mean. Yeah, no shortage of mud. Already got it on my hands. All right, so the first Tough Mudder I did was in Vegas, Laughlin, and it was more gritty, sandy. It was just wet sand and not so much mud. This time, it is straight up mud. I mean, you can already tell just a little bit behind me, but this whole area is just a big, gigantic mud pit. So this is gonna be a totally different experience, but I'm looking forward to it. It's also colder. However, I jogged to the car to drop off my stuff, and just that little bit of jogging warmed me up. So I'm sure once I get running and get moving in the obstacles, I'm totally gonna be okay. But almost up here to the staging area, you can see here, so we're pulled in, some of the bigger obstacles there at the end. I'm gonna do my best to film while I do this. I'm not entirely sure. Last time my battery died, so I missed a lot of it. This time I have this battery and another one on me, so it should be okay. And I'm holding you on a selfie stick with a tripod, so I can always just set it next to an obstacle, do it, come back and get it. So I'm thinking it'll happen. I could have done that last time, so it'll slow me down, so I'll have to make up time on the run. But here we go.
Brought his own flag, sir. Would you mind unfurling that and holding it high for us?
Oh,
Yes. Awesome. How many people, this is your very first Tough Mudder ever? All time you got out here with this man.
Woo!
That's the first time for y'all this way right here. Mudders, are you ready?
See, the beginning part of a race, I realize it's like sometimes annoying because A, people cluster up and you don't want to run too fast. So, and it can be so easy to get caught up in the excitement, I've learned. And I've done that, and I come out of the gate too hot. So I gotta really make sure not to do that for this one. Super muddy. All right, coming up with my first obstacle. Gotta be honest, on the 15K, a lot of these obstacles are just like little walls, little annoying things. I mean, I record them all. But pretty sure I should record the first one, right? This is where I'm glad I have a watch. I just looked down at my time and I'm going way too fast. So I gotta slow my pace down. Because on a race like this, like if I was just running, the 10 minute pace is totally fine. Actually, it was 9:45 when I looked. That would have been totally fine. But because I do want to push, I do want to try, see how fast I can do it. And I didn't specifically train for that, which, long story. I gotta manage my energy stores. And so I can't just burn everything out on the run because I gotta have enough energy to use my muscles. And the Tough Mudder uses your full body, as all these obstacle course races do. So I can't just use everything up. All right, here we go. Next obstacle. Well, feet are wet.
I don't know, it looks pretty far.
So here's where I have a choice. You try to jump it, but that'll expend a lot of energy jumping each one, which, as you can see, it's very difficult to climb out. So, choices to make. I will not be filming this one. I gotta tuck you away. Well, that was muddy. I am officially, I mean, it's already drying off. It's just soup. Like, I mean, this. Like, this stuff is just gnarly to run in. I am regretting that I did not drop that off in the car. Because I really like it. I don't want to leave it behind. It's going to be too annoying. I will leave it behind. Okay. Let's keep going. And here's where we split. At this point, right? Okay, so it looks like a wobbly thing. Let's see how much does it wobble. Oh, it wobbles. Oh, slippery shoes. This makes it fun.
Yeah. We should,
Okay, did it, man. But so bad. Oh, a water one. All right, this is gonna be fun. Yeah, head first.
Head first,
way easier.
You got it, Matt.
I couldn't breathe. Oh. All right. Since I'm recording, you get to. Oh, wow. So here's the problem. When I get water in my ears, I get vertigo. And right now I've got some really, right now I have some really bad vertigo. Like, I feel like I'm about to fall over.
How cold is it?
That was very disorienting. Deez, your head first. Way easier.
What up?
Oh, fuck.
That one fucks with your mind. I mean, oh. Oh, wow. Makes you feel alive when you come out of that. The adrenaline rushing through me right now. It's insane. Okay, so when I go into the water, right away, it's for me, it's cold, and I have a hard time with cold lately since I lost my weight. And so the cold's like taking my breath away. But then literally, it's like, well, you can see, it's right there. So you can barely breathe. So what I did was I got in and I said, just hold your breath for the first bit and just pull yourself down. So I helped, but I forgot what I should have done. And if you do this, what you gotta do, I forgot you gotta hum. Because you go, it's forcing air out your nose. I got some water up my nose. And that caused a little panic for a second, just involuntary, but it happened. But as I got into it, it was better. But then the very last one was super narrow. Now the other side was easier, the guy said. But oh, I thought that was gonna come much later. That one was. I'm feeling good now, though. That was. Oh God. All right.
I'm gonna have to go underneath.
I'm not entirely sure how to record myself. We're just gonna go for it. I'm gonna let you see it. You can't see a thing.
I was like, it'll clear up. I was like, it's not clear enough.
It gets worse.
Well, it was like a hallucination at one point where you're like, literally, I can't see anything.
Well, and I didn't know what to expect with the gas. The gas wasn't that bad.
Yeah. But well, you get to the second and last part, and you're like, oh, woo! It's bright. You go to snap. You're like, not yet.
Nope.
There's a fake. Yeah. I got to stand up. You're 2x4. It starts getting lighter. You're like, oh.
Oh, that was not that bad. I mean, it was. So what I did was I just breathed through my nose very shallowly, which was fine. But I just had to tell myself, just keep crawling, like it's gonna end, like it's not gonna keep going. But That one was one of those, it was not physically challenging at all. It just totally got in your head. So, not bad. That bad, that one was cool. So, the thing about these, you know, you might see the distance. And when I first, when I did my first Tough Mudder 10 miles, and the distance really intimidated me. Don't get me wrong, it's still a long way to cover on your feet. But you're taking breaks constantly to obstacles. So you catch your breath, let your heart rate come down. So the distance really isn't as bad from a car, from a running standpoint. I'd say if you could run 3 or 4 miles, you'd be okay. But it's just the overall exertion and the mental part. So they have bananas. But I like to train with the same food all the time.
What's this next one?
So here's where I'm gonna have to see if I can get someone to help me because I'm by myself. All right, so I was able to get up over it myself. That hurt though, my hand. Ow. But I did it. That is really cool. I never would have been able to do that by myself in the past. But that doesn't mean I could never do it ever, because I just did it. And my hands hurt, and I'm gonna put this down and let my hands cool off. That one is technically supposed to be done with 2 people, but I'm alone. So, I don't know what other way to do it other than that. Didn't wanna skip it, and there was no one there, although people are there, but. So a few of these obstacles, like that one I knew were coming. There's a few I'm gonna have to modify so I can do them alone. Next obstacle. Thanks. That was fun. I like that one. That was enjoyable. Right here, I'm at home. I'm in my trail element. I love running in the trail. So it was last year at the Tough Mudder that this phrasing was born. What's next? Because every time I hit an obstacle, I would just look up and go, all right, what's the next one? And I found there was something about just hyper-focusing on the next obstacle, forgetting all the ones behind, other than unless I want to reminisce, and not worrying about any others but the next one, because I'm gonna get to the one after the next one regardless. I don't need to worry about it. I'll worry about it when I get there. And I think it's a powerful metaphor for life. Sometimes just the earth itself is the obstacle.
Oh, he's carrying his GoPro.
That's right. They had a cow fence, so they just put an obstacle over it. That's fun.
You're good.
That's fun. I don't think they're counting that as an official obstacle though. Normally they have markers. That was just a thing. I think it was just their way of making us go for the fence. Where's the cups?
Here, right here.
Oh, thanks.
Yes. I'm trying to pour it. I just wasn't clicking. And there's also some Gatorade in there.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Got some good old lemon lime.
Got the one, you be careful.
So I just take a sip of water every aid station, whether I need it or not. It's just sort of breaking my brain how easy this is. And I know it'll get harder up ahead. Wait, is that my obstacle? Yeah. Like, it breaks my brain a little bit. But at the same time, I'm like, I've worked really hard to be here. And it just reminds me that what you think is impossible really isn't. Let's see, what have we got here? Kiss of mud. It's time to get dirty. Oh, and there's barbed wire. That's fantastic. I did this in Vegas and it was on sand. It was awful. All right. I am officially muddy. Here, I'll take that from you.
You feel the heavy one.
There we go. It's easier in Vegas than maybe go up a hill. But this is also much heavier. I used to weigh more than this. So here is one of the places. Here's one of the places spectators can wait. So spectators can't see you everywhere, but they can watch in different places. All right, so this is one of those ones that just, it looks a lot harder than it is, but really it's just pull-ups.
It's hot, there you go. Hell yeah.
And then can you slide down that? I realized the trick with that, I learned it last time. Just use your arms. And don't rely on your legs at all. They're basically just useful as a fulcrum. That's about it.
Yeah!
Oh yeah.
That's Chris, baby.
It's not hot outside, so it actually made that not as bad. Because it wasn't this huge shock to my system of temperature. But I don't know why the cage one was way worse.
Righty.
Hey, help, push.
Hey, who's on? Who's on? Who's on?
I'm on.
Help the ones behind
you. There we go,
That's Stoat's Matterhorn time. Alright. I'm unfortunately gonna have to peck you away. I can't get that far. Yeah, I can do hard things. It's terrifying. Alright, and away you go. It freaks me out. The adrenaline rush I get after that is intense. Mutter on. Yeah, the rings up there, they're just covered in mud. Yeah, like my forehead. Yeah, I can't. I mean, I can't. I don't have the grip strength under ideal circumstances. I can't do it with mud on it. Regrettably, I will be skipping that one. I mean, I know I could try it, but I'm just gonna press on. That's not an obstacle I particularly feel the need. Maybe next time. I didn't even train for that, to be honest. So, I got rocks in my shoes, and that is really annoying. I think I'm gonna have to stop and clean out my shoes. I really don't want to do that. But I got a couple keep really stabbing my toe. So I'm not sure how long I've been running because it says a 1 next to the elapsed time. I don't know what that means. This watch is so new, I'm still learning it. It's like slimy. Like I can't, I can feel it the moment I start letting go, my hands are slipping. Like I need, I don't know. It's just, I don't remember being that way before. But then again, it wasn't muddy in Vegas. It was sandy.
Yeah, I don't know if this will ever not suck.
Yeah.
Except for me.
In the gate, the 1 year when a guy got caught.
It's that one right there. Dude, I'm getting that. I see it. It's that one right there.
This is great. Oh! Damn! Needed that one. Shit! That sucked. Staying over here.
They do random, so just go. Ow! I got a good one. Okay. So the wind has picked up. And I'm now starting to feel quite cold. so I gotta run faster. A little bit. Get my body temperature up. All right, 8 miles. Just ticked by. All right. Well, I may have just not recorded what I did. I totally didn't make that obstacle. Like, not at all. Oh well. Can't win everything, right? Now we just go, what's next? What's the next one? Let's go. Quite honestly, I'm just sick and tired of crawling in the dirt.
Let's go.
Oh, I'm cold.
I'm gonna carry an extra butt with me now.
All right.
Are we still so far to go?
I don't know if my back is better or my stomach's better, but I'm going on the back. It's not hard, it's just... it just sucks. There we go, there's a low spot. Oh yeah. There we go. I tell you what, trail shoes have been a game changer for the tread. So I can push myself. Oh gosh. Fuck. Aid station. I'm wet and muddy and having a great day. How about you? Oh, this looks fun.
My wife doesn't get muddy. My wife doesn't get muddy.
Oh, no. She can volunteer.
Oh, yeah. It wasn't that bad. I don't have very calloused hands anymore. Something like this is like really hurting my hands. All right, in the home stretch, we got another obstacle. Oh, that is muddy. Oh, thank you. One thing I realize is I'm sitting around opining about how terrible something is while not moving forward doesn't seem to be very helpful. I mean, I personally don't mind just acknowledging that something sucks. I'm just like, yeah, that was hard. Because I think there's something about saying, letting myself know I did something that was hard. And then acknowledging the difficulty of it. But standing around, building a monument to my difficulty without forward progression, that just doesn't seem very productive. Sometimes in life, we just get stuck overthinking things. Okay, let's do it. Oh. There we go. That one surprisingly got me quite a bit, quite muddy. Like little clumps of mud. Oh, wow. Everything is just sloppy, goopy, muddy. Last time I got hurt on this one, I hurt my arm. So I don't feel like running the risk of hurting myself. So to do this penalty obstacle, I don't have to do that, but I'm gonna do that. Number 20 times, okay? That just made me hella dizzy.
Turn him apart. Oh, that poor guy. And it spit him out on the ground. Like a big old piece of gristle. Just. My man. Peekaboo. Peekaboo. Oh, this is awful that you people like seeing this happen to people.
I don't even know what I want to do. I can just crawl underneath it in the water. But then I gotta be soaking wet. I can take the obstacle, the penalty, which is a plank for 100 seconds, which feels just insultingly simple. Or I could just run through it. And this is where it like totally fucks with my mind, because I don't know what I want to do. Do I want to just go through it, or do I want to just take the penalty obstacle? Which is planking
Come on, we need a runner. We need somebody to get everybody going. Let the infinity through. Let's do it. But here it is. My man. Come on.
All right. Got my 15K and my two-time finisher.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Well, that was fun. Morning, afternoon, whatever it is. I need one of these.
All right, just that one?
Yeah.
It's like $5 somewhere. It's morning somewhere.
Yeah, that's right.
You want one of the thermogenic ones?
No, thank God. This is my absolute favorite. This one right here. Appreciate it. Oh. Very ready to go to the rinse station. So I got my bag. So the clean off after this was actually a bit of, I was not prepared at all for this last time. So here's what I learned. First, as I said before, all of my clean clothes are in a bag already here. And then in here, I got a bag for my shoes ready to go. And I have to pee so bad. Rinsed off, cleaned off. The baby wipes were great because I had like mud on my arms and stuff that I didn't notice. So it's nice just to be able to rinse that off. Second tough mudder done. This was substantially easier than the first time. So this time, you know, I recorded as I went. So I had to really pause longer so I could get the footage. But I think I want to do another one though, but I don't record anything so I can really push myself. and see how fast I can do this. But I am ready to go get me a lunch and then rest. I am tired. That was a great, great workout though. But I could tell I could have, my body has a lot left in me. I mean, if I really needed to push it, I could. It would be hard. Whew, I'm getting cold. I may have to pull out my Under Armour. I think I'm gonna do that. Oh, Under Armour on, that is much, much better. I was freezing. Okay, I'm back in my room. I don't know if you can, this shows up on camera. I got like mud in my hair. Let's see how my, I can tell, I can feel it. I've got like mud all over my back. I want to see what I've done here. And I desperately want to shower. It's not that bad. But I feel scratched up. Overall, super fun day, super fun race. But I'm ready to clean up and just rest a little bit.